true perception, knowledge. The world you see is an illusion of a world. God did not create it, for what he creates must be eternal as himself. Yet there is nothing in the world you see that will endure forever. Some things will last in time a little while longer than others. But the time will come when all things visible will have an end. The body's eyes are therefore not the means by which the real world can be seen, for the illusions that they look upon must lead to more illusions of reality. And so they do. For everything they see not only will not last, but lends itself to thoughts of sin and guilt. While everything that God created is forever without sin, and therefore is forever without guilt. Knowledge is not the remedy for false perception, since being another level, they can never meet. The one correction possible for false perception must be true perception. It will not endure. But for the time it lasts, it comes to heal. For true perception is a remedy with many names. Forgiveness, salvation, atonement, true perception, all are one. They are the one beginning, with the end to lead to oneness, far beyond themselves. True perception is the means by which the world is saved from sin, for sin does not exist. And it is this that true perception sees. The world stands like a block before Christ's face. But true perception looks on it as nothing more than just a fragile veil, so easily dispelled that it can last no longer than an instant. It is seen at last for only what it is. And now it cannot fail to disappear, for now there is an empty place, made clean and ready. Where destruction was perceived, the face of Christ appears, and in that instant is the world forgot, with time forever ended, as the world spins into nothingness from where it came. A world forgiven cannot last. It was the home of bodies. But forgiveness looks past bodies. This is its holiness. This is how it heals. The world of bodies is the world of sin, for only if there were a body is sin possible. From sin comes guilt as surely as forgiveness takes all guilt away. And once all guilt is gone, what more remains to keep a separated world in place? For place has gone as well, along with time. Only the body makes the world seem real, for being separate, it could not remain where separation is impossible. Forgiveness proves it is impossible, because it sees it not. And what you then will overlook, will not be understandable to you, just as its presence once had been your certainty. This is the shift that true perception brings. What was projected out is seen within, and there, forgiveness lets it disappear. For there the altar to the Son is set, and there his Father is remembered. Here are all illusions brought to truth and laid upon the altar. What is seen outside must lie beyond forgiveness, for it seems to be forever sinful. Where is hope, while sin is seen as outside? What remedy can guilt expect? But seen within your mind, guilt and forgiveness for an instant lie together, side by side, upon one altar. There at last are sickness and its single remedy, joined in one healing brightness. God has come to claim his own. Forgiveness is complete. And now God's knowledge, changeless, certain, pure, and wholly understandable, enters its kingdom. Gone is perception, false and true alike. Gone is forgiveness, for its task is done. And gone are bodies, in the blazing light, upon the altar to the Son of God. God knows it is His own, as it is His. And here they join, for here the face of Christ has shone away time's final instant, and now is the last perception of the world, without a purpose, and without a cause. For where God's memory has come at last, there is no journey, no belief in sin, no walls, no bodies, and the grim appeal of guilt and death is there snuffed out forever. Oh, my brothers, if you only knew the peace that will envelop you and hold you safe and pure and lovely in the mind of God, you could but rush to meet Him where His altar is. Hallowed your name and His, for they are joined here in this holy place. Here He leans down to lift you up to Him, out of illusions into holiness, out of the world, and to eternity, out of all fear, and given back to love.